गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस एंड वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द डिफरेंट फोर्ट्स एंड पैलेसेस दैट विल बी द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन फॉर अस टुडे फ्रॉम द स्पेशली फ्रॉम रिट एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। बट स्टिल दोज अदर्स दोज आर इंटरेस्टेड टू नो मोर अबाउट द फोर्ट्स एंड पैलेसेस ऑफ राजस्थान दे कैन गो अहेड दे कैन लिसन टू दिस। सो वी विल स्टार्ट विथ आर फर्स्ट फोर्ट नंबर वन हियर दैट इज नोन एज कॉल्ड जैगर फोर्ट इन जयपुर which is located in Jaipur. As you can see, this is the name of the fort and here is the name of the place. So you can see and you can see the image also. I have put the image also for you guys so that it becomes easy for you guys to remember, right? You can have a schema of it in the time of examination. All right, guys, we move ahead. Okay, and before we go ahead, guys, I would like to tell you that this video I want to divide into two parts because there are many forts and palaces so that all cannot be covered in just one video. Alright, so what I am going to do, this will be the part one of it and in another part I will come up with the remaining forts and the palaces of Rajasthan. So let's see what all this is about. So here we are talking about Jaigarh Fort, okay, and this Jaigarh Fort is situated on Chil Ka Tila, okay, that is also in English it is called Eagle Hill. And it was built by Kokil Dev in 1036 to 39. This was the duration between it was made. And Man Singh, that was 1589 to 1614, and Mirza Raj Singh 1621 to 67, and Sawai Jai Singh 1700 to 43. And this forts overlook towards Amir, and it is called a mysterious fort also. So they may ask you the question in such a way, they can frame the question like which fort is also known as called a mysterious fort. Okay, or which fort is located at the top of Chil Ka Kila or Eagle Hill. Now, this has three routes. Okay, when we talk about its entrance, that is your one is called Dungarpur, another is called Avnipol, and third is called your Bhairavpol. Okay, this fort is connected to a tunnel, okay, from Amber Fort. While going from Amber Fort to Jaigarh Fort, there are four doors. Okay, which are these four forts? That is Hathipol, your Mahapol, Dhrupol and Ganeshpol. In this fort, there is a Vijayagadi Palace, which is called a small fort in which Sawai Jai Singh took his brother's imprisonment, Vijay Singh. Okay. In this Vijayagadh fort, that the Amber rulers had their arms, treasuries and cannons, making factor, which was the only artillery in Asia. Here Asia's biggest Jayaben cannon, okay, that is also known as called Runbank, is kept, okay, which is run only once. Okay, here run only once means it this particular cannon is utilized only once. It roared so much that the women and animal beast got miscarried. Okay, it shall fell in Chakshu where the Golalwal pond was formed. Okay. The firepower of this cannon is around 35 kilometer, weight is 50 tons and length is 20 feet and weight of its shells is around 50 kg. And there is a puppet house, okay, and a Charbagh style garden in this fort. In this fort, Subhat Nivas, Diwane Aam, Khilawat Nivas, okay, that is called Diwane Khas, Lakshmi Nivas, Lalit Mandir, Vilas Mandir, Surya Mandir, Aram Mandir and Ranuji's Chowk are located. Okay, so these are the some of the famous things which are located in this particular fort. Alright, guys. Okay, guys, now this is our fort number two of the day. It's known as called Amer Fort. You can see the visuals of it. Okay, have a careful look. A name is mentioned over here, Amer Fort, and location is also mentioned, Jaipur. Try to remember the image as I'm telling you. Okay, this may help you in the exam. Now let's go ahead with our discussion ahead. Okay, so now we are discussing Amer Fort. It said this Amer Fort is situated on your Kaliko Hill. Okay, the fort was built by Minas, and in year 1207, this your Dholaria son, that is your Kokila Dev, snatched it from Bhutomina and took possession of it. Took possession means it was under their control then. And it is also called Amer Durg or Ambavati. This is another name of your Amer Fort. Okay, Ambavati, which fort is also known as called Ambavati. So that is your Amer Fort. Now your Kokila Dev and Bhurmal rebuilt it, and Mughal Man Singh I gave it a modern form in 1592. Okay. In 1707, Bahadur Shah I named it as Mominabad. Okay. So they may ask you the question that which ruler gave it Amir Fort as a name called Mominabad. Okay. So that is Bahadur Shah I. Okay. And what is the another name of it? They can give you in the option this. So this could be one of the right answer over here. The architecture of this fort has a mixture of Hindu-Muslim style. Now, why it has been having the mixture of Hindu-Muslim style? That is very, very simple. We have first it was built by this Minas, and then later on Bahadur Shah makes some changes in it, right? Some alteration. So that is why it has become the mixture of Hindu and Muslim style. In this fort, your Jaleb Chowk, Singh Pole, Ganesh Pole, Diwane Aam, Diwane Khas, this is your Dil Khush Mahal, Balbai Kai Kashal, and Mawatha Talab, etc. These are the, some of the famous things which are located in it. Okay, you can read these names carefully. I am not going to read all these names for you. Alright, guys? You just go through this, pause it, and read it, all these names. Now, among its poles, the Ganesh Pole has been described as the most beautiful door of the world. By who? By Ferguson. So this question may be asked that who described Ganesh Pole as the most beautiful door in the world, or which pole of Amir Fort is known as called the most beautiful door of the door in the world. That way it can also be asked. So this fort is connected to the tunnel from Jagadh Fort. Okay. Okay. Now another important aspect or things which you need to know about Amir Fort is that Queen Kanakwati, okay, of Man Singh I, built a Jagat Shiromani temple in the memory of her son Jagat Singh. Okay, in this temple, okay, the idol of Lord Krishna, and the temple, which temple we are talking here? We are talking about the Jagat Shiromani temple. So there is an idol or the statue of Lord Krishna, which Mirabai used to worship in childhood. Therefore, it is also called Mira temple. Okay. So this you need to remember. This is the another name for Jagat Shiromani temple, is also known as called your Mira temple. Okay, and here we have the five entrance doors of your Amir Fort. And which are these? These are your Kesi Darwaja, the door to go to the Manison of the Thakur Chur Singh of the Banaskas, and Pina Minas Manison door, Bheru Darwaja, and Suraj Pole Darwaja. So these are what? These are the five main doors of your Amir Fort. These are the entrance door of it. Okay, next we have Nehargarh Fort of Jaipur. Remember the name, location, and here is the image of it. Alright, so what is the use of image? Image help you to remember that this thing you have seen, you have studied somewhere. So this will help you to recall your data at the time of examination. Alright, guys. Okay, next we have this fort that is called Nehargarh Fort, which is in Jaipur. So this fort is also known as called your Mithdi. Okay, and it was built by your Sawai Jaisingh in year 1734 AD. And why it was built? It was built to protect Jaipur from Marathas. So according to a legend means a story. Okay, as much as of this fort was built in a daytime, this is believed. And at night, it was broken due to the miracle of Nahar Singh Baba. Then at the behest of Pandit Ratankar Pundarik, okay, Nehar Singh Baba's Chhatri was made and named the fort as Nehargarh, the temple of Lord Krishna in the fort. Okay. So this fort is also known as called your Sudarshangarh. Okay, so if somebody will ask you that what is the another name of your Nehargarh fort, so that is known as called your Sudarshangarh, because Sudarshan was the name of your Lord Krishna's chakra. Alright. The another important thing is said that most of the palaces in these forts are built by your Ram Singh II and Madho Singh. Another important detail that this fort is also known as called Crown of the Jaipur. So they may ask you that which fort is known as called your Crown of the Jaipur. So that is your Nehargarh Fort or the Sudarshan Palace. Okay. And it says that this is your Sila Khana and Hawa Mandir. These are the two of the guest house of your Madho Singhs, which are located in the Nehargarh Fort. Okay guys, the next we have Chittorgarh Fort. No need to mention you, no need to tell you that where it is located, as the name itself suggests, it's a Chittorgarh. Alright, so we see the details of now Chittorgarh Fort here. First look at the picture of this. So let's have a look at the important details of Chittorgarh Fort, and which was built by our Chitragud Maurya. Okay, Chitrangud Maurya in 7th century. Chittorgarh Fort is the oldest fort in the state. So if they may ask you this question, which fort is the oldest fort in Rajasthan? So answer should be your Chittorgarh Fort. Right. The fort is built on a hill called Chitrakoot. It is southern eastern gate of the state. It is said to be a grah to Chittorgarh, baki sab gadiya. Alright. So let's have a detailed inquiry about this Chittorgarh Fort. It says the Jaimal's Mansion. In Chittorgarh Fort, the mansion was built during the time of Maharaja Uday Singh. The first door of Chittorgarh Fort was named as the first one we are looking at. The first door, it is named as your Pandupol. Okay, and the second one is known as called your Bhairavpol, and the third gate is known as called your Ganeshpol, is the third one, and the fourth gate is your called Lakshmanpol, and the fifth pole is known as called your Jodhanpol, and sixth one is called your Tripolia. Seventh gate is known as called your Rampol. So total there are seven poles in Chittorgarh Fort. Our next point says that Vishnu's Vara Avatar, that is your known as called Kumbha Syam Temple, is also located in Chittorgarh Fort only, and it was built by I am talking about your Kumbha Swami Temple. It was built by Maharana Kumbha. And one of your famous, that is called your Vijayastham, is also situated in Chittorgarh Fort, and its height of the Vijayastham is around 120 feet. Okay, its next point says that Chittorgarh Fort was built by Maharana Kumbha to commemorate. Commemorate means to celebrate the victory of Sultan Muhammad Khilji of Malwa. The architect of this stamp is Jaita. The Vijayastham is called your Ajay Bhagar. Okay, this location called, that is called Ajay Bhagar of Hindu gods and goddesses. Yes. This fort is located at the confluence of your Gambiri and Betaj river. When we talk about the height of this fort, so it is around 1850 feet above the sea level. Further, say the biggest attraction of this fort, this palace, is your Rani Ratan Singh's Queen Padmini, that is also known as called your Padmavati. That is the biggest attraction for this Chittorgarh Fort. The main water sources in this fort is your Bhimalta Kund, Ram Kund, and Chitrangmuri Pond. It is the largest living fort till date. The main temples of this fort are your Kumbha Swami, Miran, Srinagar, Chanwari, Neelkant, and Kalika Mata. This fort is also known as the biggest fort of Rajasthan. Further, it said there is a window located in the north direction of this fort, and that window is known as called your Bari Ki Lakota, Bari of Lakota. In this fort, there are 9 court houses. Okay, Navlakha Bhandari built a small fort which was built by Rana Banvir. A water machine that is called Arhat. Okay, it's also located in this fort, and there is a mythological story which suggests that Bhima extracted the water here with his knees on the Mahabharata, during the Mahabharata period. Okay guys, in the series, our fifth fort of the day is your Ranthambore Fort, which is located at your Sawai Madhepur. You can have a look of it clearly. I can remove it for you in the sec. Now you can see, pause it and have a look at it, that how this fort looked like. And if you look at the details of your Ranthambore Fort, so it says it's an ancient Giri fort located in your Sawai Madhepur. It was built by Jagat Jain, and the first Saka was held in your 1301 AD in Ranthambore Fort. And it is surrounded by around 7 hills. And Ranthambore Durg is situated between Aravali and Vindhyachal mountain ranges. And Ranthambore Durg is also known as called your Durga Dhreen. The real name of this fort is your Ranthapur, okay, meaning of which is the Valley of Ran. Further, it said there is a famous temple of Ganesha in the Ranthambore Fort. where the huge fair is organized every year on the Ganesh Chaturthi occasion. The east of Ganesh temple is an unknown water salt called Ganga. Hamir Mahal, Supari Mahal, Badal Mahal are some of the famous palaces in this fort. Okay guys, this is the fort number 6 of the day, that is called Kumbhalgarh Fort, which is located in your Rajsamand. So you can have a look at this picture here, beautiful fort. Okay guys, now we will see the details of it. If you look at the detail of this Kumbhalgarh Fort, so it is its location, it is located in the Rajsamand district. This fort was built by Maharana Kumbha in the memory of his wife in year 1443 to 1458. This was the duration when it was built. And Abul Fazal has said about this fort that this fort is built on such a high that when looking down from above, the turban placed on the head can fall. Kumbhalgarh Fort was designed by your Gujarati Shilp Mandan. Okay, this fort is also known as called the Great Wall of India. So they may ask you the question that which fort in India is also known as called the Great Wall of India. So your right answer should be Kumbhalgarh Fort, which is located in your Rajsamand. And now why it is called as a Great Wall of India? The reason is because its entire ramparts means we are talking about its boundary walls, okay, is so wide that for the horsemen and even people can walk on it. The fort has a Kumbha Swami Vishnu temple, okay, which was built by Maharana Kumbha in it. Okay, now this Kumbhalgarh Fort has its other names, and what are these other names which is known by? It is known as called Kumbhal Meru, Kumbhapur, Kamlamir, Mahindra and Mohar, and also known as called here Sudhyo Fort. So these all are its different names of it. There was another fort in Kumbhalgarh and which is known as called your Kartar Grah, which houses the Maharana Kumbha's palace. Okay, so they may ask you the question that Maharana Kumbha's palace is also known as called. So this is your answer, that is Kartar Grah. This fort is located at the highest part of the citadel, which is known as called Kartar Grah due to the straight climb. This Kartar Grah fort is also known by nickname, that is Mewar's Aankh. Okay, Mewar's Aankh is eyes. The total length of the wall of Kumbhalgarh is around 36 kilometers. So 36 kilometers is a very, very long distance, guys. Alright. So this all, guys, in this video. And I will come up with a part 2 in which we will discuss more about the forts and palaces of Rajasthan. I cannot give you everything in this one video, otherwise it will be too much for you guys. Well guys, thank you for watching and have a nice day and keep preparing for your exam. Bye bye.